Zero at Disney Cars Toy Club, and I am super excited to be bringing you guys this video today. We're going to be opening up an entire case minus one of the Loyal Subjects Nickelodeon Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. This is wave number one. We're going to open up 15 out of the 16 blind boxes in this video. We also have a Raphael Play-Doh egg and a Splinter Ooze action to open up and show to you. Now we're going to start the video off by opening up our first Loyal Subject blind box. And we've done the Kidrobot full box. We've done the Funko Pop Mystery Mini Ninja Turtle full box. So this is going to be a completely different company. This is Loyal Subjects. It's the same people that made these. These are the Transformer blind boxes. And let's just go ahead and get the first one opened up. I'm just like so excited about these. I think these are actually going to look better than the other ones that we've shown here on the channel. But we're about to find out. I'm going to be disappointed if they're not, because I honestly think these are gonna look better. And for our first one, we got Shredder. And Shredder is a 2 and 16, so he's a common. And there are a few mysteries in here. There's some chaser figures that you can get. Now, one of the very first things that I noticed about this figure, which is actually gonna separate it from the other collectibles, is this one actually, you can move a lot of the pieces. Like his wrist moves, his arm actually kind of bends. His feet move, his legs move, his head of course can move left or right, but you can also tilt it up and down. So these actually move a lot more than any of these other ones. Like these are the Kid Robot figures, and as you can see, you can't really move these too much. I mean, they're stiff and they really only just move up and down. You can't move their legs. Same thing with the Funko Pop Ninja Turtles. You can't really move them all that much. So let's go ahead and open up the second box. That Shredder was really cool though. I'm glad that these look nice. I mean, these are some nice looking figures. I can't wait to see what a Ninja Turtle looks like. And there's our tear strip. And we got Casey Jones. And he comes with his classic bat, his golf club, and his, what else is it there? His hockey stick. And I didn't show you guys the card. Here's Shredder's card. There's Casey Jones' card. And here he is. So I'll get his weapons in his hand real quick and we'll check them out. So here he is, and I was trying to pop his head off so I could put his little golf bag around his neck, but his head doesn't seem like it wants to come off, and I don't want to force it off and actually break it. So I'll just kind of let it hang back there, but you can store his weapons in there. And as you can see, he's holding his bat. Let's open another one, put him right in front of our Krang back there, and we're gonna have to move Raphael back just a little bit. And we've done a Donatello Play-Doh egg, we've done a Leonardo egg, now we've done Raphael. The only one that we haven't done yet is Michelangelo, so we'll have to do him next. And we got another Casey Jones. So that kind of answers the question of if you're gonna get duplicates. You are gonna get duplicates if you buy the case. For this one, we finally got one. And we got, I couldn't tell if it was Donatello or Leonardo, but it is Leonardo. Here's his card. The blue was so dark, it almost had like a shade of purple to it when it was sitting in the bag. And he comes with his two swords, and it does look like you can actually put the swords right there. So I'll get them put together and we'll check them out. And here he is holding his ninja stars with his swords on his back. And yes, the swords do come out, so you can actually take both of them out. These are actually the first types of Ninja Turtle collectibles that I've seen that you could actually probably play with. Of course, I'm a little too old for that, but for the younger audience, these are some that you could actually probably play with because they move so much, and they're pretty well put together too. Like when I was trying to pull his head off, I put a lot of force into it and I couldn't get it off. Now let's take a little break from the blind boxes. This is gonna be the Kid Robot Ooze Action Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Splinter. This one does glow in the dark. We have done the Donatello one on the channel. We haven't done the other ones, but this is a pretty cool figure. And let's just go ahead and get it out of the package so we can take a better look at it. And this again is Kidrobot, and just like with the Krang that I showed you earlier, you can only really move his arms and you can't move his legs. You can move his head left or right, and that's about it. So you can't really move him around like you can with these newer Loyal Subject figures. And it's a really cool figure. I like how they did his tail, his rat tail. That's pretty nice. It would have been even nicer if they actually could have given him a real tail that actually came off of his body, but I guess they didn't want to do that. But we'll set him down, and let's go ahead and open up the next blind box. And I think the one figure I want to see the most, of course, is my favorite Ninja Turtle, Donatello. And if you're wondering why I said at the beginning of the video why we're only going to open 15 out of the 16, I want to save one blind box for tomorrow's egg video, because some people don't watch the videos every day, so I want to mention in that video that we did open this entire case today, so I want to save one blind box for that. So it looks like we got Karai. I don't know how to say her name. I haven't actually watched a lot of the newer Nickelodeon shows. So here she is, and she actually comes with these little tiny arrows. So you actually get these little itty bitty arrows to go inside of this case, and on her back you can have the sword, and of course it's just like Leonardo's sword and it pops into the back of her, but there's only one place to put that, so you can't have the little arrows and the sword on her somewhere. You can only just hold one and then pop the other one in the back right there. And I do want to point out, these arrows are razor sharp, and I mean razor sharp. That would definitely cut some skin, so you have to be careful with those. So we're on to number 5, and let's get the top of this off here. And I love it when I can just rip the blind boxes apart, because I'm not going to plan on keeping them. And it looks like we got another one of her. Same thing. No difference there, so we'll just keep going. And nice, we got Splinter. Oh wow, he looks awesome. Wait till you guys see this. So here's the card first, and look at him. He looks like he is ready to do some serious battling. Wow, he looks awesome. He looks kind of mean though. They gave him just completely white, bright eyes. Like, his eyes just glow. Like, especially when the light hits it. Man, they're just really shiny. And, of course, they actually did give him a rat tail. Unlike this one, they did give him a tail. And for the weapons, he's got his trusty staff, a bow and arrow, and a holder for his arrows. So I'll get all that taken out, and we'll check them out. So a few interesting things about our Splinter here. For one, his bow, you can actually bend the string a little bit, so you can't do that with her bow. And also, you can move him like at his waist, like you can actually turn him at his waist. So he actually moves a little bit more than the other figures, so that's kind of interesting. And you can't really move his tail too much, but you can fit all three arrows in there if you kind of just really jam them in there. But he is real, man, he is cool. He might be the coolest figure that we've opened so far. I do like the Shredder though. That Shredder looks pretty nice too. Let's see what we got for our next one. I will say though, out of the Ninja Turtles from Kidrobot, Funko Pop, and now this one, I don't think I like these the most out of the Ninja Turtles. Now the other figures, like that Shredder and the Splinter, those are probably going to end up being my favorite from all the sets, but I think I might like the Kidrobot or Funko Pop Ninja Turtles a little bit more than these. So it looks like we got a foot ninja, and he comes with several weapons. Now I'm not sure if he's on the box. He is not, so this is going to be one of the two rare ones, I guess. I don't know which one it is. There's a 1 in 24 and there's a 1 in 96, and those both look like foot soldiers. So I'm not sure which one he is, and it doesn't really tell you. Yeah, it doesn't tell you on the card which one you got. It just says 10 of 11. So I'm not sure if this is the ultra rare or the 1 in 24, but I'll get his weapons taken out and we'll check them out. You can't really store his two Grim Reaper-like scythes anywhere because there's nowhere to really put them. And I decided to go with these instead of these. And again, these are just really, really sharp. In fact, if I pushed a little bit harder, it'd probably make me bleed. So you have to be kind of careful with these because, man, they are sharp. I mean, you can tell just from looking at it, that is one sharp weapon right there. And I was looking around at this one, and I noticed up here on the top, it's kind of like the paint is like smudged up there. It almost looks like black ink or something was just smudged on the top of his head. But that is a really cool figure either way, though. I really like that one. We'll set that down, and let's go ahead and open the next one. I'm kind of curious as to which chaser I got. I'm going to have to look that up later, figure out if I got the rare one or the less rare one. And for this one, oh, nice. We finally got another Ninja Turtle. So we got Michelangelo, and he has a really crazy look on his face, and he's got a pizza where he's torn a slice of it off. That's pretty cool that they gave him a pizza, and of course his classic nunchucks. So here we go with Mikey, and he's eating a cheese, and I'm not sure if that's anchovies or not, but he's eating a cheese pizza, whatever it is. Looks kind of like a nacho cheese pizza. And here he is with his weapons. And you know, I haven't really been showing you guys the back of the figures too much. In fact, let's give a little comparison here. Here's Leonardo. There's a look at the back of both of them. Now, if you notice, they're actually different colors. They used a different shade of green. Like Michelangelo's a little bit lighter and Leonardo's a little bit darker. And of course, they also both have different expressions on their face. And even their feet look a little different. So that's really cool. They actually did spend a lot of time making these figures look different. Let's go ahead and open up our next box. So it looks like we have six left after this, and we will finish off the case minus the one for tomorrow. And this one's gonna be another Michelangelo. No difference there. Move on to the next one, and we're gonna open that egg here in just a moment. Still have not gotten Donatello. If I don't get Donatello, I'm gonna be so upset. I really want Donatello, so this is gonna be Raphael. And here's a look at his card. So look at the back. Of course, he's on the front of the box. And here's his weapons. He also comes with those foot soldier weapons, but they're a little bit different. Like, this is the one that came with the foot soldier, and if you notice, they're actually made a little bit differently. And here's a look at his weapon. He actually has a really cool weapon right there. But if you notice, he's also a little bit darker than Leonardo, so it looks like they gave every turtle their own shade of green. So that's pretty cool. He definitely looks like he's ready to start fighting somebody. And these aren't that sharp. The other ones are real sharp. This one's not too bad, so they didn't make that one too pointy. We'll set him down, and let's see if I can sneak out another blind box without knocking that egg over. And then once we open this one, I'll go ahead and show you guys what I got inside of the Play-Doh egg. And this one feels like a pretty big one. I wonder what this is. Okay, this one is another Splinter. So we're starting to get some duplicates now, but let's go ahead and open up that egg. Let's see what we got inside of this egg. So here's our Raphael surprise Play-Doh egg, and I'll let you guys in on a little secret before I open it up. There's a Ninja Turtle item in there, but I also put two other things in there that's not Ninja Turtle, because I didn't want to do just one item in this egg since it was such a big egg. I wanted to make sure that we put a few things in there for you guys. So we have the Ninja Turtle dog tag. We've shown a few of these on the channel. And then we also have these. These are two of the Marvel Money World zipper pulls. So we haven't done these in a while, and I figured, you know, they don't really go with Ninja Turtles, but it'd be neat to do it in this video. So let's go ahead and check out the dog tag first. And nice, we got Leonardo. So here's our Leonardo dog tag. This is number 7 of 24. And here is the sticker that goes along with it, which of course is Donatello. And let's go ahead and open up our first zipper pull. These things are really taped shut. I'm about to use the scissors on these. All right, so here we go with number one, if I can get it open. There it goes. Wow, they really wind the tape around on some of these blind boxes. And these things are tiny. Let's see what we got here. And if I can get it, oh, okay, there we go. We got Wolverine. That thing is so little. And this, of course, you could use on a keychain or on a zipper, so either one. They're just so tiny. And it says Marvel on the back. Not a lot of detail on that. It looks like the paint was just kind of splattered on there. So let's see what we got for the next one. We already got the one that I wanted, I think. Or maybe this is actually, this is a different series. We got a Doc Ock that was in one of these types of boxes, but this one actually doesn't even have that one. So maybe this is the first time we've opened one of these. I don't know. We've done so many Marvel blind boxes, it's hard to even keep track of them anymore. And if I can get them out... Whoever it is stubborn. There we go. And oh, is that the Incredible Hulk? It looks kind of strange for the Hulk. What is that? Yeah, okay, it is the Hulk. He looks kind of weird with the silver eyebrows. That kind of caught me off guard there. I was looking at him like, okay, it looks like the Hulk. but he looks a little different there. And let's go ahead and open up our final three blind boxes for this video. And I'm starting to get pretty nervous that we're not gonna get Donatello. And we got another Shredder. So we're down to three, well, these two here and then the one tomorrow. And man, if I don't get Donatello, I'm gonna have to order him like separately off eBay because I want him to complete my set. So let's see what we got here. I want to say one of the chasers looks kind of like April O'Neil. Okay, that's a sigh of relief right there. Where's his weapons at? Kind of hiding back in there. So there's his bow, and he also comes with a wrench that looks pretty dirty. It's like a dirty wrench with oil or grease or something on it. So here's our Donatello with his bow and his wrench. And again, I remember when I called this his bow in another video, a lot of you guys were like, that's not a bow. I guess some of you thought I meant like a bow and arrow, but his staff is actually called a bow. So it is supposed to be called a bow. Now, one thing I noticed when I was looking at this one is you can actually move their bandanas, and same with all of them. All their bandanas can be moved, so you can kind of pose it in different directions so that you can give it just a little bit more of a unique look to it. But that is really cool. They spent so much time making these different than the Kidrobot and Funko Pop figures. They went that extra mile and made them all different colors, and they all come with lots of weapons. So that's really cool that they're at least different than the other two companies. And for our final blind box, let's see what we got here. We got another Donatello. I spent all that time complaining that I wasn't going to get one, and then now we got two of them in a row. So here it is, one more time. And if you want to find out what's in the final blind box, be sure to check out the egg video for tomorrow. It's going to be a good one. We're going to have a lot of new blind boxes in there. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. This is Zero at Disney Cars Toy Club. And as always, thanks for stopping by.